Hello, hi, my dear friends. Welcome to my channel HSR BioInfo. Today in this class, we are going to discuss digestion of lipids, how digestion of lipids takes place in the human digestive system. Let us start. See, human digestive system that digests the lipid molecules. We know very well what is the digestion. Digestion is a process where conversion of macromolecules into the micromolecules. Conversion of macromolecules into the micromolecules, that is nothing but digestion. If this material, digestive material, is a lipids, that is called as a digestion of lipids. That means conversion of large particles of lipids into the small particles of the lipids. Okay, let us see how digestion will take place in the elementary system of the human. We know very well elementary system that start with the mouth. In the mouth, especially the digestion of lipids cannot be take place because of the elementary canal. Mouth does not contain the any lipid digestive enzymes. That means there is no lipases. That's why in the mouth there is no digestion of the lipids takes place. But one point to be noted here, the mouth which releases the lingual lipase. But actually this lingual lipase is activated in the acidic condition. Actually we know very well, the saliva which is present in the mouth that does not contain the acidic condition, saliva actually contains the normal pH. That's why lingual lipase which is produced by the mouth that does not act on the lipids that is present in the mouth. So lingual lipase that mixed with the food that finally enter into the stomach. See here, stomach actually produces the acids. Stomach actually produces the acid. These acids that contains the acidic condition. So, acidic condition which is present in the stomach, that's why lingual lipase is activated in the stomach. And where it acts on the lipids. It acts on the lipids, especially triacylglycerols. Triacylglycerols. See, triacylglycerol is a lipid moiety. In all these triacylglycerol, lingual lipase is active. So, then what it produces actually? Triacylglycerol acted by on the triacylglycerol, lingual lipase is acted and which produces the some products that is called as a monoacylglycerol fatty acids. Is it clear? Then coming to the stomach. Actually, stomach that contains or produces the heat due to the production of the acid. And also stomach contains the peristalsis mechanism. And also stomach stores the food up to 4 hours. See, due to the presence of heat, the lipids which are present in the food can subjected to the digestion. And also due to the peristalsis mechanism, the lipid moieties that converted into the small particles. At the same time, it stores the food up to the 4 hours. In this duration of time, peristalsis heat along with these two, there is a stomach lipase. Stomach lipase or gastric lipase. Stomach lipase or gastric lipase is the enzyme which is produced by the stomach. This stomach produced gastric lipase that act on the especially milk, act on the milk of infants. Milk of infants. You can see stomach produces the lipase that act on the milk of infants. Actually, the milk that contains the lipids, in this lipids that contains the triacylglycerol, in this triacylglycerol, fatty acids length is very less. Very small length of fatty acids which are present in the triacylglycerol of the milk. So, actually stomach lipase that act on these small fatty acids that released small fatty acid absorbed by the stomach wall. Absorbed by the stomach wall. See, actually in the stomach lipase or gastric lipase is act on the milk that produces the small fatty acids. These small fatty acids is absorbed by the stomach wall. Okay. At the same time, there is a lingual lipase that act on the triacylglycerols that also produces the fatty acids, but they are not a small length fatty acids. Commonly they act on the small length fatty acids and also long length fatty acids. In this way, stomach that digests the lipid moieties which are present in the food. Okay, it is clear. Next to the stomach, the food that mixed with the acids in the stomach, that is called as the acid type. The food items that mixed with the acids, that is called as the acid kind. This acid kind enter into the stomach to duodenum. Stomach to the duodenum. Actually, stomach that connect with the duodenum, that's why the food items, whatever that present in the stomach, that must be entered into the duodenum. Actually, duodenum is a very important part in the digestive system. Because of the duodenum which connect with the bile duct and also pancreatic duct. Bile duct, pancreatic duct. This bile duct that produces the bile juices, that bile juices mixed with the food item. This pancreatic duct that connect with the duodenum and this produces the pancreatic juices. These pancreatic juices are also mixed with the food item at the site of duodenum. Okay, so what are the bile juices and what are the pancreatic juices that contains the enzymes which is essential for the digestion of lipids? We will see. Coming to the topic, see how duodenum that helps in the digestion of the food items with the help of pancreatic juices and also bile salts. You know, bile salts actually that contains the glycopolate तारों को ले, ग्लाइकोकोलेट एंड टारोकोलेट्स आर दी सब्सटेंसेस आर साल्ट्स दैट आर प्रेजेंट इन दी बाइल जूसेस वेयर एज पैनक्रियाटिक जूसेस पैनक्रियाटिक जूसेस दैट एक्चुअली कंटेन्स दी लिपिड डाइजेस्टिव एंजाइम्स दे इंक्लूड दी पैनक्रियाटिक लाइपेज pancreatic lipase and this also contains the one more enzyme phospholipase A2 and also contains the phospholipase and also contains the colipase. But actually pancreas that contains the pancreatic juice that contains the pancreatic lipase and also phospholipase A2, phospholipase and also colipase. All these enzymes are very essential along with the glycocholate and taurocholates. Bile salts and also pancreatic juices which are actually where it is present, all these are present in the small intestine. Small intestine. Let us see. Another small intestine, rest of the part. Rest of the part of the small intestine, excluding the duodenum, that contains the enzyme that is called as the intestinal lipase. Let us see each one part actually how they are involved in the digestion of the food. Actually, we have to note a point here. Glycocholate and taurocholates are the bile salts. They cannot directly involved in the digestion of lipids. They cannot directly involved in the digestion of lipids. Instead, they involve indirectly in the digestion of the lipids. So, pancreatic lipase and phospholipase A2 and colipase. Here, pancreatic lipase is a very important enzyme. Actually, these pancreatic lipase that act on the lipids which are mostly present in the food items. Phospholipase A2 and phospholipase that act on the phospholipids. Colipase is the enzyme, it gives support to the action of pancreatic lipase. So, intestinal lipase also enzyme that act on the food items, especially on the lipids. Finally, due to the action of intestinal lipids, the lipids that convert into the very small particles. Okay, let us see how they are acting. Actually, let's see pancreatic lipase is a hydrophilic. Pancreatic lipase is a hydrophilic because that is present in the water. So, this pancreatic lipase likes the water. Whereas, lipids are hydrophobic. Hydrophobic that means, hydrophobic in the sense, lipids are the moieties that doesn't dissolved in the water. So, lipids are the water haters. These pancreatic lipase enzymes are the water lovers. See, actually hydrophobic nature, hydrophilic nature, those both are the very different. very contrast to each other. But what actually to be done, pancreatic lipase only that act on the lipids. How these lipids that convert for the action of pancreatic lipase is the question. So that question is fulfilled by the bile salts and also phospholipids. Actually, the answer for this question is due to the presence of the bile salts and phospholipids. See, bile salts plus phospholipids. Bile salts, phospholipids, actually these two moieties that contain the amphipathic nature. Amphipathic nature is the condition where these moieties, those contain the both hydrophilic and hydrophobic moieties. Hydrophilic plus hydrophobic. So, these two moieties are very essential for the digestion of the lipids. How it will done? Let us see. Actually, there is a large particle of lipid. This large particle of lipid is initially bind with the bile salts and phospholipids. What actually these bile salts and phospholipids are exist is they existing like this. It looks like micelles. This is a lipid. This is called as a phospholipid plus bile salts. But actually it contains amphipathic nature, hydrophobic and hydrophilic. Outside this ball like structure is a hydrophilic. Inner side this streak like structure is a hydrophobic. What actually these two are involved in the digestion. See, these structures that act on these lipids and break down these lipids into the smaller particles. Break down these large particles into the very small particle and it surrounds these structures. It surrounds these micelle-like structures. It surrounds the micelle-like structures. This is called as a lipid. This lipid is surrounded by the micelle-like structures. These large lipids that convert into the very small lipids with the help of the phospholipids and bile salts. This type of structures and this type of mechanism called as a emulsification. So, emulsification is the condition where hydrophobic lipids that are present in the hydrophilic water as small droplets, that called as a emulsification. That is called as a emulsification. So, what actually next process is going on? So, here the phospholipids and also bile salts surrounds the small particles of the lipids. These small particles or lipids must be digested into the small, very small particles by the action of the pancreatic lipase. And what actually going on? See, this is called this is a lipid moiety, and also it surrounds the phospholipid and basal micelle. So now this area is a hydrophilic and this is a hydrophobic. This hydrophilic area is combined with the enzyme that is called as a phospholipid, called as a pancreatic lipase. This pancreatic lipase combined with this area with the help of colipase, with the help of colipase enzyme. Colipase enzyme actually supports the pancreatic lipase to bind with the this area. Now this pancreatic lipid that enter into this area and act on these lipids, act on these lipids and break down these lipids into the small pieces. Break down these lipids into the small pieces. Now, in this way, pancreatic lipases act on the lipids which are present as an emulsification, which are present as emulsification process. So that such type of lipids are digested by the pancreatic lipase. Now these are the phospholipids. These phospholipids are digested by the enzyme phospholipase A and phospholipase. These phospholipids are digested by the enzyme phospholipase A and phospholipase A. So see, actually this contains this type of structures, hydrocarbon chains along with the hydrophilic knob. These phospholipids A2 and phospholipase that act on these phospholipids that converted into the in these three forms. One is knob-like structure is called as a hydrophilic structure, that is called as a glycerol. That is called as glycerol, and also it acts on the hydrocarbons of this glycerol, triacyl glycerol. It releases the free fatty acids. Again, it contains the phosphoric acid. So this enzyme also releases the phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid from the phospholipids. Okay, it is clear. We completed the colipase that supports the pancreatic lipase. We completed the phospholipase A2 and phospholipase A. And also pancreatic lipase. What actually pancreatic lipase doing? Pancreatic lipase act at the site of 1 and 3 fatty acid chain of triacyl glycerol, TAG, triacyl glycerol. This phospholipase A2 that act on first carbon and third carbon, it releases the second carbon along with the fatty acids. This is called as a monoacyl glycerol. Now, due to the action of phospholipase, it releases the free fatty acids. Free fatty acids plus monoacyl glycerols. Now, the enzyme which actually present in the intestine, that is called as the intestinal lipase, this enzyme act here at the second carbon of fatty acid and glycerol. Again, it releases the free fatty acid and also glycerol. See, finally what we have get free fatty acids and also we got the glycerol and also we have phosphoric acid. So what actually that converted triacyl glycerol to the free fatty acids and glycerols and phosphoric acids. Okay, so this is the complete digestive process of lipids. So after watching this video, if you really understand this concept, please do subscribe my channel HSR Pandya Info. Like, share and comment. Thank you.